Hello everyone, Kaney here and welcome to Advanced Furnaces for Minecraft 1.8, 1.9 and higher. This command block contraption allows you to upgrade your furnaces so they can run faster and more efficiently. The first thing you need to do when installing the module is installing the custom crafter module made by Accidental Games. A link will be on screen and in the description down below. So if you copy the one-click code for the custom crafter, paste it into the command block and power it with the stone button on the side. You notice that the contraption will appear right before it in the positive X and Y direction. After you've installed the custom crafter, you can get the one-click command for the advanced furnaces, paste them into there and power it again with any redstone source. And you'll notice that the contraption will appear in the positive X, Y and Z direction two blocks from the main command block itself. So when you've executed both commands, you'll notice that the redstone blocks start bumping up and down, and then you know you are ready to go. So yeah, let's get straight into it. The module adds three new kinds of furnaces, one of them being the iron furnace, the second one being the obsidian furnace, and lastly the diamond furnace. And the furnaces have a nice little plate on top. This one is an iron one, this one is an obsidian one, and this one is a diamond one. You cannot see the blocks very well because they are not active yet. When they are smelting, you notice that the plates all get brightened up. So the iron furnace will smelt 8 seconds per item, and the obsidian will smelt 5 seconds per item, and the diamond furnace will have a whopping 2.5 seconds per item, so you can really smelt some stuff with this one, all opposed to the normal furnace, which of course smelts with 10 seconds per item. That means that a normal furnace is able to smelt 8 items per coal. An iron furnace will smelt 10 items per coal. The obsidian furnace will smelt 16 items per coal. And the diamond furnace will smelt 32 items per coal. So it just works like a normal furnace. You plop in your coal and your gold or iron or any other thing you want to smelt. It works with everything you can smelt. You notice that the plates begin to light up, and that means that they are smelting their things. So the iron furnace isn't really noticeable, but if you take a look at the diamond one, you notice that it's smelting like a beast. Like 1, 2, 1, 2, so it's really going faster. So yeah, I'll let these smelt out, and you can see that indeed they smelt the amounts of items I told you, just so. So the furnaces are done smelting, so let's see what they have produced. The normal furnace, 8 items, the iron one, 10 items, the obsidian one, 16 items, and the diamond one, 32 items. So yeah, how do you make these bad boys? In order to create advanced furnaces, you first need to make a custom crafter. And you can make a custom crafter by placing a dropper on the ground, putting the dropper recipe inside of it and throwing a crafting table on top. That will turn it into a custom crafter, and now you can start making your advanced furnaces. The advanced furnaces work with an upgrade system. That means that you need the normal furnace for an iron one, you need the iron furnace for an obsidian one, and you need the obsidian one for a diamond one. So to create the iron one, you put the furnace in the bottom slot and you put 7 iron around it like so, and you get an iron furnace. And for the obsidian and the diamond furnace, you can do the same with obsidian. And finally, diamond blocks, not diamond items, very important. You need diamond blocks. So there you have your three furnaces. And yeah, let's activate them. Activating the advanced furnaces is quite straightforward. You just take your furnaces and you place them down. And when you've placed them down, you throw a coal item on top to activate them. And you know when they are activated, when the plate appears. So that means they are activated. And you have your advanced furnaces with also a renamed inventory name. There are a few drawbacks, one of them being that if furnaces are close to each other, it is harder to actually create them. This is to prevent duplication glitches. It is still possible, you can do it, but it's just a bit harder. And finally, when you place your furnace down, do not break it until you have activated it. Because if you do break it before that you activated it, you will lose your furnace, and that would be a pity if you have just spent 7 diamond blocks on a furnace and they are all gone. So be a little bit careful with that. Once you're done with them, you can just knock them out and you'll get your furnaces back. And these are just your iron furnace, obsidian furnace and diamond furnace items, so no furnace will be lost when you delete them. And that was the advanced furnaces module for Minecraft 1.8, 1.9 and higher. I would like to thank you very much for watching. I really appreciate it. All the links, all the download links, the link to the custom crafter will be in the description down below. So if you want to check it out, plop it in your own world and have advanced furnaces in your own Minecraft world, get the one click, install it where you want. If you want to see more, do not forget to subscribe to me. I'll be doing these weekly now, so yeah, that's really exciting. Also, follow me on Twitter. My Twitter is at Mr. Sugarcaney. I will be updating you on all the things happening on the YouTube channel, as well as other random stuff. So if you want to follow me, go to Twitter, follow me. And finally, do not forget to share this video with everybody you know. That will really help me out. So if you want to do that, thank you very much. And yeah, that's it. So I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.